This will hopefully be a brief screencast for George on the broken link checker. When you come to the dashboard on the WordPress tools, you can put this thing anywhere you want, but I've just got it in the upper right-hand corner. We'll come back to this. Let me go down to the plugins and show you that this is the broken link checker version 2.2.3. And checks your blog for broken links and notifies you on the dashboard if any are found. So that gives you the info. Let's go back to the dashboard and we can click. I've got four because I've just done some cleanup. Shows you there are four broken ones, some warnings. I really don't pay any attention to that or redirects. Sometimes I will just dismiss one if I know it's not really broken. But you see my Amazon, I've got three Amazon links here. 503 or 500 internal server error means something to you. But let's just go through and I'll show you. I'm going to view this most recent one in a new tab. And it says, the Vanish Man here, it's got a, automatically it puts a line through to say that that link is broken. But I believe if we click that, you'll see that it doesn't appear to be broken. Okay, so I have several options here under that one. I could edit the URL. I never do that. Unlink, more on that later. Dismiss, I do that sometimes, and I can't think of exactly why. I rarely recheck, but in this case, I'm just going to say it's not broken. Boom, and it automatically dismisses it. Now, if I wanted to check, sometimes I'll have 50 or 100 or a shitload of these. So I can just click here, and that selects all of them, obviously. But I want to come back to this smaze.com, so I'm going to uncheck that for now. And the options here under bulk actions is the same ones that I showed you here. Recheck, fix, redirects. Again, I'm not sure what that is. Well, I know what a redirect is, but I don't really see that many redirects. I'm going to just, because I know these Amazon links are good, I'm just going to mark as not broken, and that'll take that little line out. But you got to hit apply here, and then those two will go away. Under search, you can search for, I guess, what might be potential broken links by the link text, by the URL, HTTP code. I've never done any of those. Link status, if I wanted to see, I guess, all the broken links, if I wanted to search for broken links, warnings, redirect, link type, posts, pages. I haven't used this, but I think maybe I need to do that. But to give you an example of how this might work, I know that New York Times links now are kind of fucked up. So if I put in some text that I'm pretty sure would be in the link text. If I search that, you see I get a whole bunch of New York Times. Now, this is something I haven't seen before, so I'm going to take a quick look here. I'm seeing some stuff that says false positive. So I would think that the New York Times, all of them would be broken links now. But let's go look at that. This is a post of mine. If the news is that important to you, blah, blah, blah. And there's only one link on here. Whoops. Right? And that's right up here. It's not showing it as broken. If I click that, this story. Ah. Oh, okay. So, you know, maybe that's why it's showing a false positive. Let's try one more of those. Campaign, like at 50 sites. Let's click here. And again, only one link. And if I click it, so everything's behind the paywall. So I could probably, in fact, you know, I know that nothing's going to get through that paywall. This is an opportunity to go ahead and bulk select those and click unlink. And Well, apply, you want to share? Yeah, fuck it. That's the broken link checker. And I haven't used the search that much because I just wait for the plugin to crawl the site, I guess, find some broken links and put them over there. And so I wind up doing 20, 30, 50 at a time, depending on how many it's found in that particular scan. All right.